Well guys, Sarama here, welcome back to another video, and today we're going to talk about my thoughts on Code Geass Season 3. Now, I fucking love Code Geass. It's one of my favorite animes of all time. I love it so much, I got a DVD of it. I know, this DVD only contains the first 5 episodes of the anime, but I still freaking love it, dude. I would love to get my hands on the rest of this series, you know, and everything else. But Code Geass, I love it so much. Like, I finished all in the month of January. Like, I even did my own review on it. Hell, I think my very, very first anime review was Code Geass. Now, I wasn't as descriptive, and I was acting like a lot more personal on Code Geass, especially on my anime reviews way back then, because I took so damn long to do them. But still, I love Code Geass, and there's no doubt about that. Now what are my thoughts now that Code Geass Season 3 has been announced? You know, it was like some months ago when that trailer dropped. You know, like there was like a clip of Colin and other characters. I recognize a couple characters, including Colin. You know, they're all hanging out. You know, obviously probably celebrating like, I don't know, like an anniversary of the victory. Peace. You know. Like peace has been restored and everything. And then there was like a clip of Suzaku probably getting chased unexpectedly. I mean, why would he be jumping off a fucking motorcycle? You know, like, again, I love Code Geass, but what am I, and I heard that Lelouch does make an appearance at the very end of that. Again, I only saw like a couple clips of them, like a couple pics and stuff, and crap, but I heard that a new trailer just dropped, and I'm not gonna watch it because I don't know if I should. I don't know if I even want to watch season 3, because now look, I love Code Geass. Okay, it's one of my favorite animes of all time. I think it's fucking awesome. I think it's really smart. The characters are amazing, and especially Lelouch. And the fucking ending is one of the best endings to any series of all time. I think any anime, because the ending was so smart that they stayed until the very end. Like, now there are plot holes in the series that are kind of confusing, especially around the end. Like, how the fuck did not only reach in seeing Lelouch's mind that about Zero Requiem, but like a true plan of Zero Requiem. That was at the very end of the damn series, at the end of season 2. But like, that is a plot hole all on its own. But Code Geass season 3. If there's gonna be an entirely new fucking war going down, disturbing the peace, that would make Lelouch's sacrifice at the very end, you know, everything with Zero Requiem, completely useless. I hope to God it does not completely retcon the entire ending. I mean, I wouldn't really say retcon, but probably feel like the ending feels kind of, I mean, I know realistically a war will inevitably happen, really. I think that's pretty doggone obvious, but I fucking love the endings of season 2 so much that I just don't feel like everything that just happened should be wasted. I mean, I know it's realistically enough that another war is inevitable. because there's always gonna be some shit, some dumb shit to start a war. Obviously, I mean, of course, it happens here in the real world. Don't deny it, because some wars actually start off pretty damn stupid for some stupid reasons. But again, I just. I don't know what to think about Code Geass R3. You know, like should I be excited? Like I kind of am because all my favorite characters are coming back. I mean, we see Kalu, we see Suzaku, like, and more than likely we're gonna be seeing Nonally. Again, I just not, and again, I hear that Lelouch was in the trailer too. And the ending to Code Geass was so open-ended of like on Lelouch's fate. Like anybody has seen the original Japanese release of Code Geass R2, like the very ending. There was a clip of Lelouch with C2 on that carriage. Like he was the one riding the damn carriage, showing that he got the code that his father had ever since he died. But so if he's in the trailer, that means he actually has the code, like how C2 does. I don't know how to feel about that. I mean, it makes a lot of sense. But I feel like the sacrifice itself should. I just feel like the sacrifice, but feel like nothing. And Lelouch has to come back and figure everything out, and everything will all end happily ever after, or some bullshit at the end. You know? I don't know. I mean, it's been 10 years since season two ended and came out and ended, but I just. I don't know. Should I watch season three of Code Geass when it comes out? I mean, I love the series to death. I just feel like it's gonna suck. Cause if you look at Dragon Ball Super when that first came out, like people have been asking for a new Dragon Ball series since for years. I'm talking about. After people just straight up hated GT, ever since Z Kai came out, people didn't like it because it was just basically Dragon Ball Z just with the manga material, which is basically everything that we watched that was manga material in Z, and it was basically a re-release of Dragon Ball Z just with the manga material. People wanted a whole new series. Again, after years, and we got that with Dragon Ball Super, but a lot of people were really disappointed with like how it began. Now, when the Universe 6 stuff came out, that was when things started to get lit, and when the Future Trunks stuff came out, that was when things started to get more lit with Goku Black, Future Trunks, like freaking Zamasu, like that, like in the. And the idea of immortality being canon to another being in the series. Like, it is fucking crazy. And then there's the Universal Survival Arc, which is probably gonna be even more better. Because, again, the ending to Future Trunks arc was. It was disappointing. It was. It was rushed and was disappointing. Like, come on. You guys didn't need to pull a Bleach here. But again, like Dragon Ball Super hasn't been like what we thought it was gonna be. Like we thought that was gonna be better than Z. Let's be honest here, Toei's there because of the fucking fans. They're always doing all this shit just for the fans, so everyone can be there. But come on, dude, a lot of people are more critical, and it's probably gonna suck. I just don't want season 3 to suck. I really don't. Of Code Geass. I just hope they do it, you know, right. I hope to God that no other war is going to break down. I mean, let's say there was like a rebellion rising up because these fuckers don't like Nunnally, you know, being here or some shit. You know, like there's a rebellion rising up and Suzaku's trying to keep out the peace, and since Suzaku's her guard, you know. I mean, it would make a lot of sense. It would make a lot of sense of Suzaku being hunted down by the trailer, because there's a rebel, because there's a rebellion under the mist. I hope that's the case of a rebellion rising, and maybe we will get like a reunion of Lelouch with everybody, and it's gonna be a happy ending, you know. Who really knows? Who knows how long this season 3 is gonna be? It's probably gonna be 12 episodes, like how Attack on Titan is. I wouldn't be surprised though, because animation studios in Japan are getting closed down more and more, and that's really gonna fucking suck for everybody that loves anime. Because we're probably not gonna get any seasonals anymore, and you know, and again, I wouldn't be surprised if Code Geass got 12 episodes, and then we're gonna get like the second half like next year, you know, because that's how the Berserk anime, the 2016 anime, kind of got, and now like season 2 of that is out. But who knows? I do hope it's like a rebellion kind of rising up against, you know, the army, you know, against Nunnally and Suzaku. Actually, I think Suzaku hasn't been revealed as Z-Zero, you know, the one at the very end. You know, it's, again, so maybe people are chasing him down because they know he's Zero or something. They found his suit or something. Like, who really knows, like, what's going on? Because it looked like everybody was celebrating. Some fucked up thing has happened to that guy with the orange part mask, which I forgot his name. Because it's been a long time since I watched Code Geass. Some people are hunting down Suzaku, like he's jumping out of a fucking motorcycle on like, right next to a hill. And I heard that Lelouch did show up in the trailer. But, so, who knows? Like, we're probably gonna get, like, a rebellion rising up. And then, like, Lelouch comes back and helps out. And he's revealed to be alive. You know, to everybody. Like who knows? I do hope that Season 3 does not suck. Okay? Because recently, animes that have been returning has turned out to be either disappointing, but have gone better later on, but still kind of disappointing. Ah, damn. Like, a lot of series are coming back that are being disappointing. I mean, Berserk, I heard that the new anime is god-awful. I heard it's very disappointing with the animation. FLCL's coming back with 2 more seasons. Blue Exorcist just came back, but that was, like, a really good return. Attack on Titan just came back. I heard it's getting fucking lit right now. Again, it's been like a mixed bag with animes coming back. Like, they're having some really good ones. Like, I heard from the Blue Exorcist, the Kyoto Saga. There has been some disappointing ones. Like, again, Dragon Ball Super. Dragon Ball Super has been getting good and getting like a lot better with like a lot with like, a lot like lots of stuff. But it's just been, but it's had its moments where it's like, eh, what the fuck, dude? Like, people just straight up hate Super or just think it's straight up disappointing. I just think it's kind of decent from everything it's gone through. Because we cannot deny the bullshit that was episode 5. We cannot deny the bullshit that was the Resurrection F arc. Like, but there were, and And there was, and there are the bad ones, which I heard was the Berserk anime, like the new one. But who knows? Like, maybe it'll turn out really fucking good because because it's looking like the it looks like Sunrise are officially back on that, you know? Because it actually looks like Sunrise is actually still animating this. And, because it's got the same look, just modern day. You know, again, I hope they do it right because Code Geass is one of my favorite series. I just hope they don't fuck it up. And FLCL seasons 2 and 3, they better not fuck that up either. Because I suppose I have like 6 episodes per season with FLCL because season 1 only had 6. Yeah. But again, who knows about Code Geass season 3? What do you guys think about it? What do you guys think about season 3? Are you guys hyped? Or are you just kind of, oh, what the fuck, man? What should I think? You know, kind of like how I am. I am gonna watch that new trailer that just came out. I still don't know what. I don't know if I will or not. Damn it, because I don't want to spoil myself because we're probably gonna get like a bit of what's gonna happen, but who knows? Again, Code Geass is my shit. I love it, but I'm really skeptical because series that has been returning for like a long while has been kind of disappointing, for the most part for a lot of people. Like, people are saying that parts of season 2 of Attack on Titan kind of sucks because there was no action. Come on, you action tards, what the fuck? But I mean, let's hope it goes up to like the popular, ones that are getting a lot of hype and saying that they're getting pretty damn good. Dragon Ball Super is getting pretty damn good so far from what I'm hearing throughout the survival arc. Kyoto Saga, Blue Exorcist, and Attack on Titan season 2. I'm gonna be watching the dub. I plan on reacting to the dub this week. I plan on it for damn sure. If I can't find a way to have my Bandicam work with me reacting to the actual episode, I'm gonna flip my shit. But and what do you guys think of Code Geass RR3? Let me know in the comments down below and hope you guys kind of enjoyed it. Like the video if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you want to see more, comment below what y'all think. If you're on the channel and want to see more, be sure to subscribe for more. And again, I hope you guys enjoyed it and I will see y'all next time. Survivor out.